Hi, my name is Paul Fisher, and I'm a greenhouse specialist from the University of Florida IFAS Extension. And irrigation is the most important job that we do to produce high quality plants. And one of the most challenging aspects is to communicate with our staff when to water and how much to water. In other words, for a container substrate, how wet is wet and how dry is dry. This video illustrates the 1 to 5 moisture scale. And it's widely used to manage irrigation in young plant or transplant production, but it can also be used for any plant size. Along with my colleague Ryan Dixon, we'll cover the importance of the 1 to 5 moisture scale in the greenhouse and define the 5 moisture levels.
Good water management is critical for producing young plants. Accurately determining moisture level is a crucial skill in the greenhouse. Mistakes caused by poor water management and decisions can be incredibly costly and frustrating, thus making it important to dial in on this topic. It can be quite a challenge to train employees on how to distinguish between moisture levels. Terms like wet, dry, and moist can be unclear and easily misinterpreted. When different ideas on moisture levels develop within a company, crop uniformity becomes a big issue. So having a standardized moisture scale that is both easy to understand and easy to use will benefit the entire team. The 1 through 5 moisture scale is a tool for defining the moisture levels of growing media. This knowledge can be directly applied in your greenhouse. At level 5, the media is fully saturated. The tray is heavy and it bends under the water weight. Level 5 is seen just after fully irrigating the tray, and it doesn't last long since gravity soon pulls moisture out of the cells. The media color is black and it is shiny, and you can see the free moisture at the surface of the media and underneath the cells. At level 5, the media feels like pudding, and when holding it in your hand, water freely drips. At level 4, the media is wet. The tray is heavy and it bends. The media is holding the maximum amount of water against gravity. At level 4, the color is dark, but it is not shiny, since you don't see any free moisture. If you lightly squeeze or press the media, water easily drips out, and after squeezing, the media will hold its shape with light cracking. At level 3, the media is moist. The tray feels a little lighter and it may bend only slightly under its weight. Water is leaving the media through evaporation and plant uptake, and air is entering more pore spaces. At level 3, the color turns brown. If you squeeze hard, only a couple of water drops come out, and when you let go, the soil cracks into chunks. At level 2, the media is dry. The tray is much lighter and it may not bend. At level 2, plants must search out available water and they may start to stress. Growth is usually restricted at level 2. The media looks light brown to tan in color, and you won't be able to squeeze any water out of the soil. If you hold the media to your ear and squeeze, a squeaking sound can be heard. This sound is made by a small amount of water moving through pore spaces. And when you let go of the media, it falls apart in your hand. At level 1, the media is completely dried. The tray is very light and there is no available water for plants. The media can shrink away from the cell walls. Now it's hydrophobic and may be really difficult to re-wet. Unless you're growing succulents, level 1 will severely stress your plants. The color looks tan to white gray. No water can be squeezed out and no squeaking can be heard. The media falls apart in your hand and can be blown into dust. Be careful when you inspect media. Sometimes the top of a cell can get much drier than the bottom. If you have roots developing, make sure you base your irrigation decisions off the moisture level at the root zone. Employees from all departments should be familiar with the moisture scale. From start to finish, the whole team can monitor moisture levels, providing quality checks up until the customer receives your product. Growers can use this scale to teach irrigators watering techniques. These levels can be incorporated into your culture plans and will contribute to the future success of your crops. All employees should be trained alike so that identical skills are achieved company-wide. Learning the criteria for the different moisture levels can be fun, so take into consideration group exercises, visual aids, and quizzes when training your staff. Thank you for watching.